It's the Sunday Showcase on the Mutual Audio Network.
The following audio drama is rated G for general audience.
Hi, guys. Come on in.
What's going on, Mr. Bell?
Yeah, why'd you call us in?
And most importantly, where are the donuts you said would be here?
Well, I've got a surprise for you guys.
Ooh, I like surprises.
I don't.
Oh, don't be a spoilsport, Brad. Why don't you like surprises?
Do you remember the last time Mr. Bell surprised us? He locked us in the studio and made us listen to this really awful old-time radio show.
Oh, yeah, boy, that was a pain. But I don't think he's gonna... Why are you locking the door, Mr. Bell?
So he won't be disturbed?
I'm already disturbed.
Let us out, Mr. Bell, let us out.
Or at least give us donuts.
All right, the donuts are in that box.
Ooh.
And today's presentation is from the series The Hermit's Cave.
So it's about a hermit that lives in a cave, huh?
Oh, yeah, that's got a lot of potential for excitement.
No, you see, the hermit... Hermit is the narrator. He knows all these stories, and he tells them to everybody who will listen.
Where does he get these stories if he's in a cave all the time?
And don't hermits shun talking to other people?
He's not much of a hermit, Mr. Bell.
Well, let's find out with this episode from The Hermit's Cave.
So he's a werewolf?
Maybe he just needs Pepto-Bismol.
Well, it's a nice melody, but I don't like the lyrics very much. I'll give it a 5.
Is this how they open every episode?
I'm afraid so, yeah.
Hermit, you're next.
Hermit?
Hermit!
You're next, Hermie!
I get the feeling they got a half an hour to fill with a 15-minute plot.
Sounds like the alarm is going off there.
Ghost stories.
Ghost stories, go!
Weird stories. And murders, too.
Is he laughing or crying there?
The hermit knows of them all. Turn out your lights. Turn them out.
Hey, lights out is gonna sue you, pal.
Ah, have you heard the story? The house on Lost Man's Bluff, eh?
I can't hear anything with all that howling going on.
What?
Huh?
Then listen while the hermit tells you the story.
What a jolly hermit.
Okay, we're waiting.
There is a story here somewhere, isn't there?
Oh, they gave up. Can we quit now too, Mr. Bell? Huh? Can we? Can we? Huh? Can we?
Sorry, the show is coming back.
Oh.
The motor knows Morse code.
For heaven's sake.
What is it, Denton?
Out of gas?
Couldn't be, Charles. Denton filled up at the last stop. What is it, Denton?
For heaven's sake, man, how do I know?
Maybe the sound effects record is just skipping.
No, it's slowing to a stop.
Well, that's that.
Oh, can we go now?
No.
Ooh, I hope we don't get stranded in this forsaken territory.
Well, that'd be something, wouldn't it?
Something like...
Foreshadowing!
Yeah. Even 5-shadowing.
Shh.
We haven't passed a house in the last 3 hours.
Or even a Starbucks.
Well, I might as well get out and see what I can do.
The door won't open.
Push that thing.
No, turn the handle.
You want me to take a look at it, Denton? No.
I've seen doors before.
I'll tinker with it a while.
I'm sure he can figure out that door.
He took it off and he's dragging it around.
You and Nan sit down on the side of the road.
Or middle.
I might be able to find the trouble for you, Dad.
Charles was only trying to help, Denton.
Never mind, I say.
Stop with the constant bickering!
I have a thing going in a moment.
Restroom's over there.
Do as I say, sit along the road.
First it was next to the road, now it's along the road.
I think he's got it in for these people.
I'm going to work.
Come on, Charles. Let's do as he says.
Just as you say, Denton.
Here's a nice place to sit, Charles.
On this roadkill.
We can look right down into a valley from here.
In the middle of the road?
Oh, it is nice, isn't it?
We can have a light wine on the white line.
See? You can look all over the valley.
Hey, why look over the valley when you can look...
Down in the valley!
The valley's so slow! Can we speed this up a little bit, please?
I wonder what they call this place.
I wouldn't know.
That's a funny name for a place.
Oh, look.
C-Spot.
C-Spot, run.
Run, Spot, run.
Or Puff will get you.
We're not so far from civilization as I thought.
A town at the lower end of the valley.
I got a pain in my lower end.
Where the valley is.
Now, that's still a long way away.
No, it's right back here.
You see?
Not without a mirror.
The road takes a roundabout way along the rim of the valley.
You think we should skip this next joke?
Uh-huh.
Good.
Say, I bet that's where I'm going to work.
Okay, I bet that's where I'm going to work.
Do you think so?
I'll just bet you that's where the job is that Denton got for me.
Way out?
Dude.
Totally.
Away from everything?
Oh, I don't know. Looks like a nice little town. I'll make out all right.
Oh, you sly dog.
I hate to have you leaving us, Charles. I'll be terribly lonesome.
Oh, I'll get back to the city occasionally.
You must be sure to do that.
Sure I will.
What's my next line?
Man.
No, that's not it.
Denton can't hear us talking from here, can he?
What?
Speak up!
We can't hear you talking from there.
No.
I have a feeling that he managed this job for me way out here because he didn't want me living with you two anymore.
Oh, no, Charles. Why should he object to my own brother living with us?
Maybe because you're a freeloader?
You never clean your room.
Or help with the dishes.
You've got me there. I can't figure it out.
It ain't no Rubik's Cube, pal.
He doesn't like you.
When I first came to stay with you, Denton talked of getting me work close by.
I know he did.
Man, there's something strange about it.
I don't know exactly what you mean, Charles.
Neither do we.
Yes, you do.
No, we don't.
Ever since Denton came back from that road trip, he's acted strange.
Now that you mention it, I think I have noticed something different about Denton.
He was jolly and friendly enough to me when I first arrived.
He came down the chimney.
And left his presents.
And now all of a sudden he's changed.
His underwear.
Maybe we're imagining it all.
Doesn't seem that he'd be jealous of his wife's own brother, does it?
No. Denton's not like that.
But he has been for the last 10 days. Morose. Sullen?
Dour, gloomy,
melancholy, mournful,
surly, in a funk.
Sitting most of the time staring at me.
Maybe he feels I've been paying more attention to you than to him.
Maybe that's it.
No, that's not it.
It's only natural that I'd be solicitous of my own brother.
You're soliciting your own brother?
Whom I haven't seen for so many years.
We won't talk about it anymore.
Thank you.
That's a relief.
All I hope is that he isn't ill.
And he keeps talking about it.
That you aren't going to have trouble with me so far away.
You said we mustn't worry about it. We won't.
No.
I do wish he'd get the car started.
Yeah, he's been awfully quiet over there.
He wouldn't let me help him. Fairly pushed me away.
I can understand that.
I certainly would have.
Denton's frightfully independent.
And very quiet.
But I wish he'd hurry.
Nervous?
I think we're going to have a storm.
Shouldn't there be a stormy sound effect or something here?
Hold on, it's probably just late.
We should be getting out of these hills and down into town quickly.
There's the sound effect.
Such as it is.
Say, sky is getting black and gloomy.
Okay.
The sky is getting black and gloomy. All the way to Gitchy Goomy.
Look over to the west. Clouds are piling up fast.
Shows this dialogue.
Something of a wind coming up, too.
Denton just stands there looking at the car as if he didn't know what he was doing.
Maybe he doesn't.
Neither do we.
Well, let's go back over. Maybe you'll let me help him now.
All right.
Watch your step. There are jagged pieces of rock here.
That wind's getting stronger every minute.
It sure is. Looks like we might be getting a tornado.
It's a twister! It's a twister!
How are you making out, Denton?
In the back seat till you showed up.
Located the trouble?
We should hurry, Denton. There's a terrific storm coming up fast.
Really? The sound effects kind of petered out there.
Can't make the car go if it doesn't want to.
Sure you can, just turn the key and step on the gas. It's not the car's decision.
Look at the sky, Denton.
Where?
We're in for a real storm.
Sound effects are back.
Wow, there goes my hat.
Too bad I didn't take his head with it.
No use chasing it now.
Please, hurry. Get the car started.
All right. All right, get inside. Maybe it'll go now.
Keep smacking things until it starts.
Ow!
Let's hurry.
Someone's giving us a raspberry.
We'll have to drive like mad to get out of these hills and into the village before the storm breaks.
I know these roads. I'll get you out all right.
Denton, don't be so cross. Jump on every word Charles says.
Then don't give me orders.
Sir, yes, sir. Whoa, who opened the window back there?
What?
How black it is.
What?
Turn on the lights of the car, Denton.
And turn down the sound effects. There's more wind here than you get from fill in name of favorite politician.
You'll never be able to keep the car on the road with a wind like this.
What are we going to do, Denton? It'll blow the car off the road and hurl us down the hill.
They're firing their cannons, sir!
How about we prepare to return fire?
Wow. That was a peal of thunder.
Yes, that thunder had a peal.
Denton, we can't drive on, is it?
No, I know we can't.
So turn off the sound effects record.
What are we going to do, Dan?
Yeah, Dan.
What, Dan?
We sit in the car and be safe? We aren't going to sit here. We're going to make for shelter.
But where?
There's a house sitting up there on the rock.
Maybe it's the Hard Rock Cafe.
It's so dark, I can't see it.
So high, I can't get over it.
There's a house up there. I got caught in a storm the last time I was through here.
And you didn't learn your lesson.
Climbed up to that house and stayed until it blew over.
The house blew over?
Should have made it out of bricks instead of stakes.
Can we get up there all right? We can make it. We'll have to. Get out of the car. We've got to start right away. Hurry. Come on.
What?
Give me your hand, Dan.
I can't understand what you're saying. Ow!
It's in the middle of the afternoon and black as night.
Did she say the black night?
It's the black night!
I'll save us!
The black night always triumphs!
Oh, yeah? Take this!
All right. We call it a draw.
Now, we've got to climb fast. And I'll take hold of hands and start up the rock.
We get to hold hands.
We've got to get to that house. We've got to get there. Give me your hand, man.
Let's go.
Hurry.
I want to hold your hand!
Now your foot! Now your elbow!
I'm running out of appendages!
3, 2, 1, lift off!
And Friendship 7 is heading off into space!
We're here. Are you all right, Nan?
All right. Knock on the door, Dan.
We don't have to knock. We walk right in.
Sit right down!
What?
Sit right down!
Hurry. Get inside.
Ow!
Huh. What a relief. I thought for a few minutes we might not make it. I'll bolt this door so the wind won't rip it open.
Who owns this place?
Want to buy it? Tell you what I'll do.
Doesn't anyone live here?
You can with a small down payment.
There was no one living in it when I stopped on my way through here last time.
But it must belong to someone. It's completely furnished.
That's going to cost you a little extra.
Whoever owns it hasn't been here for a long time then. Everything's covered with dust and cobwebs. I can see them even in this pale light.
Next to this lighted pail.
Oops. Ooh, Mr. Bell kicked the bucket.
It's so dark in here.
Wait, who's the dork in here?
3 guesses, Brad.
Can't you find a lamp or something, Denton?
I'll get a light.
Just 1/3 the calories.
There's one in this room off the hall.
Come on, Charles, let's follow him. I don't like standing in this dark hall.
Alone with you.
I found a lamp. I'll have it lighted in a moment.
Oh, damp and cold in here.
Is she going to complain during the entire show?
Why not? We are.
Ooh, good point.
Ooh.
I didn't do that.
Keep your hands to yourself, Brad.
Is this a pregnant pause?
If so, it's in its 9th month.
There. Huh. Light makes it better, doesn't it? Some.
Maybe.
Perhaps.
Possibly.
Could be, or not.
I don't like the looks of this place.
At least we're out of the storm, Dan.
That quiet storm that's raging outside.
You stopped here on your last trip through, Denton? And there was no one living here then?
That's what I said, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's what I said. I said that. You heard me say that. Nah.
But it's completely furnished. Surely someone lives here now.
Maybe they do.
And don't call me Shirley.
They aren't here now.
Almost like a dungeon in the room. Windows are built so high.
Maybe it's a dorm for the basketball team.
Something like a fort. But it's Grand Denton knew of this place. It shelter out of the storm.
Give me a shelter.
The wind couldn't blow this building over.
Denton?
What?
What are you staring at?
What?
You heard what I said.
What?
What are you staring out into the hall for?
Where do you want me to stare?
Maybe you can stare down the stairs.
He's a real staircase.
Say, Dan.
Okay, Dan.
Are you all right?
Don't clench your hands that way. What do you see?
Did I say I saw anything?
Did you see what you saw?
So you saw what you could see?
Did you saw the seesaw?
What's the matter with you?
Sorry, we're just kidding around, lady.
She's too sensitive.
Don't keep asking me questions. I've got you out of the storm. Isn't that enough? Now leave me alone.
All right, how much do you need?
Where do you see our interest rates?
Where are you going?
He didn't hear you. Try again.
Where are you going, Denton? Stop him, Charles.
Don't you think we all of us sit in here? When the storm blows over, we can drive on.
Drive on what?
One would hope the road.
What's wrong with him? He's moving like a person in a trance. Get him to come back in this room.
Does everybody wear wooden shoes in this show?
Maybe they're going Dutch.
Are you ill, Denton? Is there something we can do?
Stay right where you are. Both of you.
What is it?
I'm going into that...
phone booth?
Starbucks?
Plot device?
That room across the hall.
But why... why don't we all stay together?
Stay together?
In a horror show?
What is she thinking?
It's dark in here. I don't like it. I want you to stay near me.
She is a bit of a whiner, isn't she?
I said I'm going into that room across the hall.
So there, yeah.
And I'm going alone.
Oogie, oogie, oogie.
Your brother Charles will take care of you.
In my old age?
You prefer his company, don't you?
Frankly, we're not too fond of any of you.
Is that what's wrong with you? Why do you act this way toward my brother?
You should act toward the audience.
You might as well make up your minds, both of you, that we'll stay in this house until morning. I'm going into this room.
Why?
To sleep.
Okay.
This is a pretty big cabin.
I see him disappearing over the horizon.
Denton!
It's no use.
He is ill.
He's got it in for me.
What's he got in?
And why couldn't he do it himself?
Come on. Let's go back where the lamp is.
Listen. You hear what he's doing?
He's rearranging the furniture.
Again?
He's going to mess up the feng shui.
Barricading the door.
What does all this mean? Oh, Charles.
Let's get back to where the lamp is.
A lot of walking around in this show.
It's as if he's lost his mind.
Has he checked behind the lamp?
Sit down.
How far away is that chair?
It's been coming on him for some time.
Another pimple?
Ever since he made that last trip through here. We know that.
I didn't know that. Did you know that?
I didn't have a clue.
What shall we do?
See what I did there?
Oh, hush.
Why did he go into that room and leave us?
She can't take a hint.
As soon as we get into town, we'll persuade him to see a doctor.
Dr. Phil?
Dr. Demento?
Dr. Who?
Let's make the best of it now.
Oh, you sly dog.
If he wants to leave us and sleep, let him.
Oh.
It's tough on you, Nan. I'm sorry I brought you all this trouble.
Denton's never been this way before.
Large and green.
There's something dreadfully wrong. What was that?
The shadow knows.
Oh, is that Denton laughing?
No, it can't be. He's never laughed like that in his life.
I don't think he's ever laughed at all.
What a jolly fellow.
It's coming from the room Denton went into. That's for sure.
He's going mad. Oh, Charles.
Come on. You'll have to let us in.
Denton? Denton, what is it?
Is this a cabin or the Taj Mahal?
Let us in. Dan, let us in.
By the hair of my chinny chin!
Locked.
Bolted and barricaded.
Nice alliteration.
Denton, please let us in. It is coming from in there. But it's not Denton. It can't be.
Maybe he's sublet.
Oh, what are we going to do?
I'm sorry, what was that?
What should we do?
Why do anything? He sounds happy enough.
Sounds like the room he's in is pulling away from the station.
Everything's all right now, Nan.
He's on his way to Anaheim.
Azusa!
And Cucamonga!
He's quieted down.
He answered you the last time you went over to the room?
Yes. He said, I'm all right. Go away.
And you still can't take the hint.
Maybe they need some Tic Tacs.
Oh.
I think he's going to sleep now.
Wait a minute. How would they know that?
That was kind of an odd conclusion to come to.
Maybe he's just enjoying listening to the Mutual Audio Network on his earbuds.
Oh, nice plug, Arnie.
Let's help him out a bit. Replay that last segment, please.
Oh.
Me, 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 me.
I think he's going to sleep now. We might as well do the same.
I can't sleep in this horrible house.
Yes, you can. It'll only be a few hours before morning.
What if Denton refuses to come out of that room in the morning?
He'll be better in the morning.
This guy's just making all sorts of assumptions.
Maybe he's got a crystal ball. No one's touching that line, huh?
Nope.
No way.
Storm's passed over, too.
And it's being followed by a cold front, which will come down through the mountains to make things a bit breezy in the morning.
Everything will seem different in the morning.
Leave the lamp burning. I'm scared.
Sure. I'll set it on the mantel. It won't bother our eyes, but it will shed some light.
Maybe it'll shed some light on this plot.
Yes, that will be all right.
See, she agrees with me.
You think Denton will sleep?
I think he's asleep now. I'd break the door down then if I thought it would do any good.
And if I was strong enough.
But I think it's best to let him get over this spell by himself.
Oh, now it's a spell. First they rip off lights out, then they rip off the shadow, now they rip off Harry Potter.
I'll never believe it was he laughing.
So you don't think it was he?
Who could it have been but Denton?
Maybe it was the Joker.
Oh, now don't worry anymore. Try to get some sleep. If he calls out, I'll wake you up.
It seems like a nightmare, doesn't it?
Welcome to my nightmare.
It will in the morning.
No, that would be a daymare.
Everything will be different then.
Yeah, your nose will run and your feet will smell.
Go to sleep now. You need the rest.
Rest of what?
What do they have that they're not sharing with us?
How about some wind?
Well, I did have beans for lunch.
I do believe the storm is back.
Must have been on a coffee break.
Well, it's certainly making up for lost time now.
And there it goes.
What in the world is that sound?
A robot frog?
A robot frog making one of those kind of phone calls.
Maybe he needs my inhaler.
It's the third runner-up in the Darth Vader impersonation contest.
Oh, now they're doing a duet.
Well, at least we're getting a good night's sleep.
Charles, wake up! Wake up!
What is it?
Wake up! There's someone standing over you.
What?
One more time.
Wake up. There's someone standing over you. They're going to kill you. Charles!
Good heavens. What is it?
It's over here in the next county.
Ow!
What was that?
Oh, Charlie.
Please do your best owl imitation while I talk to you.
He stood right over you with his hands reaching out for you.
Who?
And when I screamed, he ran.
For heaven's sake, who?
He was going to kill you.
Here come the police. We're saved.
No, I think those are dogs.
Calm down, Mr. Bell. You're not one to judge other people's appearance.
Oh, no, it's the hermit.
Terror-stricken, Charles and Nan stand in the middle of the room in this strange house on Lost Man's Bluff, wondering who tried to kill Charles.
Anybody got any ideas?
You mean other than binging some Netflix show?
I'll make the popcorn.
Oh, no. You're not getting off that easy. If I gotta stay, you gotta stay.
No.
And you have to listen.
Listen?
Listen?
Listen.
He's feeling our pain.
And enjoying it far too much.
Maybe those aren't dogs after all. Maybe that's the live audience crying to get out.
You mean you think it was...
I know it was Denton.
Oh, that's ridiculous. Denton trying to kill me.
I know it was he. With his hands reaching out for your throat.
Oh, no.
And when I screamed...
Ice cream? No.
He ran back into that room and closed the door. Charles, where are you going?
I'm going to get him out of that room before something really happens.
No!
Let something happen!
We beg of you!
You mustn't go near him.
I've got to. No, you stay here.
Never. I'm going with you.
I'm going to make him let me in there.
He may try to kill you again.
I don't think he will. You stay behind me.
This cabin gets bigger and bigger.
Denton?
I'm doing the dishes.
Denton!
With all that knocking, they're denting the door.
The door's unlocked.
And no one thought to try that earlier?
Men saw they ain't.
Denton? Stay back, man. I'm going to light a match.
Hold your finger a little further down. I won't burn you like that.
Great heaven. Denton.
What is it?
Get back. Don't look.
Ow!
Why are you closing the door? What is it, Charles?
It's a door.
What did you see?
The other side of the door.
Denton's...
Something's happened to him.
He's trying to tell you.
Something's happened to Denton.
Let him tell you.
What is it, Charles? Tell me quick. What is it?
Well, we're way past quick.
Denton's hanged himself.
Ooh, one down. Two to go.
Keep hold of yourself, Nan. We've got to get out of here.
He's right. We got to get out of here.
We got to get out of here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. We got to get out of this place.
Nope. Sorry. Back to the action.
We've got to get out into town and get the authorities here.
Maybe a pizza.
What? You don't like pizza?
Don't hang yourself.
Let's hope the car runs. We've got to get into town.
Don't panic. Maybe they deliver.
The lamp drug in.
Wait, what was that?
The lamp drug in.
The lamp drug in?
What did the lamp drug in? Hopefully our pizza.
Look, up at the top of the stairs.
It's a bird.
It's a plane.
What is it?
In this faint light, it looks like the figure of a man.
And a fine figure of a man he is, too.
Yes, but you can see right through him.
Kind of like this plot.
That's the worst laugh track I've ever heard for a show.
What? He's disappeared.
Standing there at the head of the stairs, pointing at us.
Ow!
Then vanished.
That same laughter.
Charles, you're not going up there.
Apparently not.
Unless he's wearing sneakers.
We're going to get out of the place right away.
We gotta get...
No.
Spoil sport.
And get help. Quick. Hurry, we must get help.
Help?
Help?
I tell you, it's urgent. You've got to go up there right now.
Go up to that house on Lost Man's Bluff?
It appears we've had a transition in time here.
Pretty classy using the Beatles as transition music.
Before daybreak?
Right now.
Oh, no. Not me.
But my husband is dead in that house.
And he's getting deader every second we waste.
Would never enter the door of that house at night. No, sir. Neither would anyone else in this town.
Denton is dead.
We'll have further updates if his condition gets worse.
He ain't the first one to die up there.
What do you mean?
Ain't never heard of the house on Lost Man's Bluff?
No.
Is that anything like Blind Man's Bluff?
We don't live around here.
Oh, well, that explains that.
What did you mean when you said that Denton was not the first man to die there?
What, are you bad at math? It means it's more than one.
5 years ago, a fella that owned that house killed his brother, then hanged himself.
What?
He said he hanged his elf.
Wonder what he had against his elf. Well, the Lord helps those who help them elves hang.
That's right.
Told you.
But hanging didn't seem to take him out of this world.
Dude.
Well, I ain't the only one that's been there, passed there at night and heard his wild laughter.
He must have been listening to bells in the...
Don't go there.
It's fit to make the hair stand right up on a man's spine.
Can you shave a spine?
Other folks tried to live in that house. But you know what happens to them when they go in a certain room in that house?
They don't get Wi-Fi?
They miss out on pizza? They notice it hadn't been sanitized for their protection?
Denton tried to sleep in.
The desire to kill enters in them.
Like we have now.
And the laughter of him that belongs to the other world drives him mad.
What other world? Saturn?
Pluto?
How about your...
No.
Guess is as good as mine.
All right. They can't get away from it. They return to the place.
Charles, that's what happened to Denton. He said he'd been in that house before.
Over and over and over again.
They try to kill. If there's anyone near to kill...
Or if there's nobody to kill, they'll kill a bottle or kill some time or go online to thesefolksneedkillin.com and go out and kill them, maybe.
And then they take their own lives. It's happened to 3 other people.
Larry, Moe, and Curly?
Groucho, Harpo, and Chico?
Abbott and Costello, and... I got nothing.
One man got back to town and told his experience.
Pretty talkative for a dead guy.
But he went back up there a few weeks later... Took his life. Hanged himself.
What do these people have against elves?
At this rate, won't we run out of elves?
Oh, no, sir.
Oh, good. I love me some Keebler cookies.
You'll have to wait till morning. Won't get nobody to go up there in the night to that house on Lost Man's Bluff.
Oh, by the way, we gave the storm a ride down the hill. Hope that's okay.
Come on in, Storm. Make yourself comfortable.
Well, at least not any annoying howling... Wolves.
Oh, great, it's hermit time again.
And the wild laughter from the house on Lost Man's Bluff continues to pierce the night. Don't ever go near it after sundown. No.
Wait, what? That's the end? No explanation of why the room is haunted?
Or how the man got lost in the bluff?
Pleasant dreams.
Oh, and we end with a ripoff of Inner Sanctum.
Well, that was a complex plot. You go to the house, you go in the room, you go nuts, you kill somebody and kill yourself. For no particular reason. Didn't take me 30 minutes to do that.
Well, you didn't have a whole lot of howling wind and howling dogs and interminable footsteps to deal with. Gee, I wonder if all the plots in the show are as thin as the hermit.
You better not have eaten our pizza.
Or Keebler cookies.
Well, guys, that was one of the many stories from the hermit's cave.
What kind of hermit was this, Mr. Bell?
How's that, Arnie?
I mean, was this a lonely hermit?
A stinky hermit?
A grumpy hermit?
Or maybe a Herman's hermit?
Oh, no, we're not going to do this. You've been listening to Bells in the Batfry, episode 240, copyright...
Hermit's Cave, you made a lousy story.
Well, boy, you can say that again.
Shows that suck that much ain't all that rare, sadly.
That's true.
When it's bad, it makes your brain congeal. The plot ain't clear enough. It's just a waste of time.
Copyright 2020 by John Bale Creative.
We want reasons for the things that happen.
They're Creative LLC.
Random blood and violence is lame.
Be sure to join us for the next Bells in the Batfry.
Be deranged, but have some logic too. Make the story clear enough. We like things more sublime. Walking about, listening with your earbuds, you'll pull them out. When the show is just crud, if you find that stories like this bore you, here's a tip to keep you feeling swell. Tune us in, the Mutual Audio Net. There's lots of quality here. And the Batfry with John Bell.
Okay, hold it. What was that last part about my...
Hermit's Cave, you had a lousy story. Hermit's Cave, you made me kinda snory. Hermit's Cave, there's more to tales than gory. Now that you're done, I'm feeling hunky-dory.
The hermit knows of them all.
Hello, I'm John Bell of Bells in the Batfry. It's a comedy podcast. Fridays and every other Sunday. Well, anyway, back in episode 5 of Bells in the Batfry, we introduced the cowlets, tiny little cows.
Where did all these cats come from?
They're not cats, they're cows, and they're heading toward the water cooler. Stop it before...
Now you can display your love of these tiny cows with genuine cowlet t-shirts.
You know what's really fun to do with these shirts? Get a whole bunch of people to buy them. Then you all gather together and run down the street. People will see these cowlets coming toward them and think it's a stampede.
You think that would really work, Brad?
Shh, I'm pushing for bulk sales here.
You can also get cowlet mugs, clocks, and other items. Just go to thebatfree.com and click on shop.
This is a limited time offer.
No, it's not.
You just do not understand advertising, do you?
Get your merchandise today with the official cowlet design created by Jeff Music.
Buying lots of them would bring music to my ears.
Oh, stop.